Hi, welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. Now we'll talk about the cosmic horizon. And it's a good idea to have checked the Big Bang video before you go into this one. The first image that I have here is that history that I showed you in the Big Bang video. So it's a history of the evolution of the universe. It started very dense and very hot here sometime 13.7 billion years ago. And as time progresses, it expands and it cools down. If you look at this image a little bit more carefully, you see that there is a time here where a lot of expansion happened. So I'll zoom in right there. There is a time of rapid expansion. That time right there is what we call the time of inflation. The universe grew so fast that objects lost, or pieces of space lost, causal contact. So for example, the universe is all of this background that I have here, okay? It's pretty uniform at large scales. And because the universe expanded so much in the era of inflation, that the universe is way bigger than what we can observe. We can only observe light that has traveled 13.7 billion years. Light only has that, only had that much time to travel and reach us. So objects that are further than 13.7 light years from us cannot be observed yet. It's possible that they will be able to be observed as the universe continues to expand, but it depends on how fast the expansion of the universe is. So the observable universe is limited, and it's centered around us, around our position here, and it's 13.7 billion light years in radius. Now, this is the size of the observable universe, and if we look at it in detail, you'll also realize that the objects that are further away from us, these blue candles here, we are detecting the light today that was emitted when those objects were very young. Light has been traveling almost the entire age of the universe in order to reach us here today. So we observe galaxies that are far away as very young. We observe galaxies that are intermediate distance as intermediate age, and galaxies that are closer to us as older, assuming that they all form together at the same time. So this is another image of the evolution of the universe with time. And you see that if we observe the universe nearby, let's say you use a telescope and we take pictures, but we don't take a very long exposure. We just observe galaxies nearby. Then we are seeing right here, 12 to 14 billion years, very close to the age of the universe today. As we look with more and more powerful telescopes, we start to see galaxies that are further away. And if we look in the infrared, we are able, or in the radio, excuse me, we are able to observe this cosmic background radiation that we talked about. So the further we look, the more in the past we look, until we look at the cosmic background radiation. And there's nothing more that we can see before, because before then, no light that was emitted was able to reach us here today. Now, there's one more tricky thing about understanding the cosmological horizon, the idea of the fact that the observable universe is finite. Let's think about this carefully. Here we are on Earth observing a galaxy that's far away. The galaxy today emits a photon of light that will travel towards us. Well, the photon will be emitted, but the light won't instantaneously reach us because it takes some time for light to travel. As the light travels, the distance between Earth and this faraway galaxy increases because of the expansion of the universe and continues to increase. So the path that this photon has to travel, that this light has to travel, is actually greater than the initial distance between Earth and the galaxy. So distances in cosmology can be tricky. When we say that a galaxy is at a certain distance from us, do we mean that it's at a certain distance today, or that it was at that distance at the time the light was emitted? You need to be careful what we are talking about. When I said that there is a radius of 13.6 billion years or 13.7 billion years around us that we can see, I meant that light has had this amount of time to travel. We can't see light that would need to travel more than that. But in reality, we can see galaxies that are now much further away than 13.6.7 billion years ago. They were closer to us when the light was emitted, but now they are very far away. So if you Google cosmic horizon in Wikipedia, for example, you'll see that the radius of the observable universe is 93 billion light years. That is because the galaxies that we are observing now, the further away galaxies that we are observing now, today are at this distance from us. So you need to be careful there. Well, I hope this helped you understand why is it that we don't observe the entire universe and there is a limit to our observable universe. I suggest you check my YouTube videos on the expansion of the universe and on the Big Bang, and that you also go read on this book, astronomynotes.com, which is a free, pretty good textbook. I hope it helped. I'll see you next time. Bye.